It was a cold and snowy evening here in Almaty, Kazakhstan, but that didn't stop the athletes at the 2017 Winter Universiad from performing at the top level. Let's look at some highlights from today. We'll start now at the men's 10,000 meter event before moving over to figure skating ice dance free dance. Then we'll stay on the ice for men's and women's hockey between Russia and Japan and Canada and the United States. We'll then wrap up with the ski jumping mixed relay and the men's figure skating short program at Almaty Arena. Welcome to the beautiful Madeo High Ice Rink. You saw the women compete in the snowy weather earlier today, and now it's the men's turn to kick it off. They will compete in the 10,000 meter speed skate event, the longest in this discipline. These ones will last a grueling 13 or 14 minutes. But first, this one is Hung Woong Moon from Korea and Suyu Ogawa from Japan. The Japanese athlete will be racing on that inside lane wearing the black. And the Korean athlete here you see, he will be on the outside lane. He's in blue and red. Eight minutes now into the race, Ogawa is just winning slightly by a very small margin as he continues on to this race. 11 laps to go now. Ogawa still in the lead. You can see him here rounding the corner. But when the final lap approached, it was Hun Yung Moon from Korea who would be out to a very substantial finish. He would end with a time of 14 minutes and 26 seconds even. Next up is a race between Italy and Austria, Italy's David Giotto and Austria's Linus Heidegger. Both athletes out to a quick start on this one, and it would be another 14 minutes until this grueling race would come to an end. You can see Giotto here. He won the gold medal in the 5,000 meter race on January 31st, and again showing his dominance here on this one. His competitor from Austria, not even in sight. Heading into the final lap now, Giotto on pace to take this first top spot. Close to the finish line here, he will end with a time of 13 minutes and 48.12 seconds. That moves the Italian up to that very first top ranking spot. You can see his beginning there. We're gonna move on, however, to the next race. This one is between two Japanese athletes. This one you see right here, he will be on the inside. This is Ichino, and on the outside in the darker with the red marker on his arm is Obashi. The two Japanese athletes go head to head. You can see here Ichino. He won just earlier in this Universiad the silver medal at the 5,000 meter event. Now 11 laps to go left in this race. He takes a quick head start. You can see him here getting a little bit fatigued as he continues throughout this race. Approaching the finish line here, he will end with a time of 14 minutes, 17.53 seconds. You can watch his final lap. With this time, he moves to the second place spot, and we'll watch Obashi just finish here. He will gain that third place spot with a time of 14 minutes and 24.95 seconds. The Japanese athletes had a wonderful race here at Madeo Mountain as they claim the second and third spot. You can see here Italy in one, Japan two and three, and Korea in four. But Japan's Ichino would be disqualified, moving Hun Woong Moon from Korea up to that third place position. The medals were awarded to Giotto, Obashi, and Moon. Next up is a different type of skating. We move now to Almaty Arena for the Ice Dance Free Dance, where couples from around the world perform dance numbers while wearing skates. It's a bit different than pairs figure skating, which is not at these games. First up tonight is the Ukraine's Alexander Nazarova and Maxim Nikitin. Their music selection is Micmac soundtrack, and the points to beat tonight for them is 77.11. This beautiful performance would end with a score of 101.5, bringing them to a total of 165.62. They move now to the top spot, so let's watch Germany's Sherry Coach and Christian Neuecht turn. They will be dancing to Romeo and Juliet by Abel Korzeniowski. This performance would earn a score of 91.68 with a total of 154. This would bring them to the second spot. But first up is Russia, Sofia Ezdokimova and Igor Bazin. They dance to a fun song, Hip Hip Chin Chin Temptation. Enjoy their upbeat performance. With a score of 93, it brings their total to 156.96. That will earn them the silver medal in this event. Here are the athletes now awaiting the final results before they get their medal. A big congratulations to the Ukrainian team. As the crowd goes wild and the Ukrainians get crowned the winners of Ice Dance Free Dance. Just to recap, Ukraine took gold, Russia silver, and Germany, they would take the bronze medal. It was speed skating and then figure skating. Now let's finish the trio off with hockey at Halyk Arena, where game one of the men's quarterfinal got underway between Russia and Japan. Take a look now at the starting lineup for this Russian team. It includes captain Dmitry Kirillov. You will see him here shaking hands and exchanging gifts with the captain of the other team, Japan's Shigeki Hitosato. He will make the starting lineup for his squad as well. Here is head coach of Russia, Vlad Kromik, and of Japan, Kazuyoshi Yamaguchi. The first face-off of the game. There would be lots of action between these two teams. Here's Russia's first shot attempt. That one doesn't go. The goalie for Japan, Shotaro Kaneko, you can see here, gets his stick right in the exact place it needs to be, stops that one from going in. Now, on the other end, Japan has the first shot attempt themselves right into the glove of Ilya Andrukov. Russia, on the other hand, they would be the only team to score in this first period with less than a minute to go. A pass from Kirill Filipenko to Andrei Arafiev would connect for Russia's first goal. At the end of the first period, Russia leads 1-0 over Team Japan. Fast forward to the second now. Russia on a power play. A small bit of a breakaway here for the team in red and blue. A shot by Roman Tatalin gets a wonderful rebound for Andrei Arafiev, and he puts that one in for his second goal of the game. Japan now looking for a comeback, a power play themselves. Hiroshi Matsu chucks one up from right in front of the crease. Look at this one. He gets it right over the right shoulder of Russia's goalie. And Japan's comeback wouldn't stop there as Shigeko Hitosaki gets a breakaway. Russia with a serious hooking call there. He would be called for it. Let's watch again here. Gets his stick right around Hitosaki, and now he will have a penalty shot. Dizzles right around the defender. That one good to tie up the game 2-2. Russia not happy with the score. They would go on a bit of a run to end the second. Take a look at this one on the power play. Zabornikov from the top nails one in from far right past the goalie. They take the lead now 3-2. A missed shot attempt here. Gets the rebound out to Kudinov. He slings one back. It gets right in that top left corner. Watch this one. Bam. Gets in there now, ending the second. Russia is leading the way over Japan 4-2. To start off this last period, it's Zabornikov once again. Watch this, the exact same spot as the slap shot before, top left-hand corner. It would now have Russia on a serious hot streak. They'd be the only team left to score. Watch here, Pilipenko in the corner, right in front of the net to Kirillov. He just knocks that one in. Now, Russia's Osipov wants in on the action, slings one back, this time on the right top corner of the net. Watch this one. Just past the defender and past the goalie now, Russia leading 7-2. There's always one goal in a game you don't want to miss, and it is this one by Pilipenko from Russia. Watch this one. Picks it up on his stick, wraps it around. The goalie doesn't even see it coming. To end the game now, the last goal, a nice pass by Elin over to Ivanov. That one will end it now, 9-2. Take a look at that one. Beautiful shot there by Ivanov. Russia takes that one again, 9-2 over Japan. They will move on now to semifinals. They will play the winner of Canada and Latvia. Bolinjstvolak Arena saw hockey action as well today as semifinals kicked off for the women. Russia took on China, and for now, Canada takes on the USA. Canada is 3-0 coming into this matchup. They beat China, Great Britain, and Kazakhstan earlier in this tournament, only allowing one goal in those three games. The USA is 1-1 coming into this one after they fell to Russia and picked up the W against Japan earlier in the Universiade. Here are the officials here before we look at the starting lineup of Canada. Two goalkeepers for Canada. Valerie Lamenta will make the start. Good call by coach Rachel Flanagan. Making the start now for the United States is Lauren Allen, wearing 31. Here's the starting lineup for the American team. Head coach Shelley Looney will make a good call on the starting lineup for this one. Again, Lauren Allen here, she will take 58 shots on net tonight by this Canadian team. First faceoff of the night, Canada will take first possession in this game, and they will stay absolutely dominant once again and continue their hot streak in this tournament. Fast forward now, later in the first period, from up top, Brianna Yazzolino chucks it in, and it's helped by Jessica Cormier. She's going to get the goal on this one. Watch it as she taps it right through Lauren Allen's pads. Canada, 1-0. Canada continues with first period action as Kylie Gavilan sets up Rachel Marriott right in front of USA's crease. Watch this one again. A nice pass, and Marriott able to just knock that one in for two goals for Canada. Less than a minute later, Erica Ryder from the top slings it back, and it goes right past the goalie. She wanted to join that club too at the end of the first period. Canada would lead 3-2 over the USA. In the second period, Canada was at it again. A nice pass by Bailey over to Dubuis. Slings it in with a beautiful slap shot there. Take a look at this. Boom, right into the back of the net. Canada now in a two-person power play. A beautiful pass by Alana Sharman over to Alexandra Labelle. Gets another one for Canada. Look at this one. Beautifully in there. That would be the first of what would be a hat trick night for Labelle. The USA answers back now with a short-handed long bong by Rebecca Senden. Take another look at this one. No one expected it. Right past the goalie. USA now has one goal to Canada's five. Kicking off third period action now is Canada's Kaylin Willoughby. Watch as she lifts that puck up top left-hand corner. Watch this. USA's Allen didn't even see that one coming. To end the game, Canada's Alexandra Labelle would go on a hot streak. She would score the 7th and 8th goal of the game. Canada will win this one 8-1 over the United States of America. Let's look at some impressive stats from this Canadian team tonight. 58 shots on goal to the USA's only 9. The USA moves to 1-2 on the tournament. They will go down now to the participation round, while Canada continues their hot streak with 4-0. They will now play in the finals against Russia to win the gold or silver medal now at the Universiade. Let's move now from the skating rink over to the slopes. Suncar International Ski Jumping Complex. They hosted the mixed relay ski jumping event tonight. It is an exciting one, and Japan, they would prove very dominant in this one. 8 pairs of athletes from Japan, Czech Republic, Russia, Poland, and Kazakhstan all competed tonight, and they would be rewarded with medals shortly thereafter. Take a look at the starting list for tonight's event. But for now, we're going to fast forward to Japan's Yuka Kobayashi. She's going just under 90 kilometers an hour. She lands this one at 94.5 meters. Take a look at the replay here. And after all 5 judges score this one, she will end with 108.4. Up next is the Czech Republic's Marta Krepelkova, who's got to beat 91 in this jump. Here she goes, 89.8 kilometers an hour. She lands just short of Kobayashi's landing there with a final meter count of 89 meters on the dot. After the judges get their scoring in, she will end with a score of 99.8 in this final round. Another Japanese team now would take to the slopes. Haruka Iwasa is up. She's got to beat 87.5. She's going 90 kilometers an hour here. Lands way long of that leaderboard with a jump of 94.5 meters. Take another look at this one. The final score for her would be 108.7 in this last round. After the women, Japan and Japan 2 are leading the way with Czech Republic and Russia not far behind. It was the men's turn to take to the platform now. Here's the Czech Republic's Česmír Kozisek. He's got to beat 97 here on this jump. Here he goes. He will land at 100 meters. You can tell he's happy with that one. His score for this final round here, as you watch this jump one more time, is 129.7. That brings him to a total of 251.7. Up next is Japan, Max Koga. Koga's got to be 96.5 on this one. Only traveling 87.2 kilometers per hour. He lands that one at 96 meters. His score after this final jump, 116.7 with a total of 229. That would put his Japan 2 team in second place. But for now, Japan's first team is up with Naoki Nakamura, one of the best ski jumpers in this event right now. You can see why he lands at 98 meters. Very happy with his performance there. Watch that one again and see why he has such a big smile at the end of this one. He finishes with 124 in that final round, bringing him to 243. That means they take the gold with 445.1. The Czech Republic with a score of 434.9 and the second Japanese team with 430.6. Both these athletes that you're seeing right now won the gold in their individual jumps, and they will compete tomorrow in the team event for both men's and women's. Let's head back to the ice now. Welcome to Almaty Arena, where the men's figure skating free skate is set to begin. Fans from many different countries filled this arena. Yes, this is the arena where the opening ceremonies was held. Now we are set to watch Sweden's Alexander Medjerov. He was the 2011 World Junior Bronze Medalist, a five-time Nordic champion, three-time Swedish national champion, and he competed at the 2014 Sochi Olympic Games. Beautiful number here by the Swedish athlete. Takes a little bit of a tumble, but he gets right back out there for a beautiful skate and a wonderful finish. You can see him here awaiting his score. He will receive one deduction for that fall that we saw, but end with 165.55. That puts him in the top spot for now. But up next is Japan's Kiki Tanaka. Tanaka was a 2011 World Junior Silver Medalist and the 2017 Japanese National Silver Medalist. Enjoy his performance. At the end of that one, 163.04. That brings him to 252.09 total score. Now he moves to the top spot, but still there's one more athlete left to go, and this athlete is from Kazakhstan. He is the 2014 Sochi Olympic Games bronze medalist, 2013 world silver medalist, 2015 world bronze medalist, the 2011 Winter Games champ, and a five-time Kazakhstan national champion. Enjoy Dennis Ten's beautiful program. At the end of this one, he will get a score of 172.06, total of 267.97. He will grab the gold medal in this event. The Kazakhstan hometown crowd, very, very proud of their athlete. Dennis Ten will grab the gold medal. And to recap, Kiji Tanaka will get the silver, and the bronze goes to the Swedish athlete Alexander Majerov.